We've got a wonderful speaker, everybody. Very esteemed. It's the founder of Islamic Relief, the Humanitarian Forum, International HIV Fund, Muslim Charities Forum, and Zakat House. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and welcome Dr. Hany Elbanna. Thank you.
I'm very honored to be with you here tonight. I'm filling the gap for Jangir, the director of Islamic Relief. That's why I don't have a presentation. But Islamic Relief started in this hall 28 years ago. My first speech for Islamic Relief after coming from Sudan for the famine in the Horn of Africa was in Birmingham University. And we raised £250 when I was doing my medical degree before Islamic Relief came out to the light of the scene of anyone and each one of you. This was January 1984 in this very room. So we are actually honored to be bromies, honored to be graduate of Birmingham University, alumni, what do you call them? Alumni. Okay. And I'm honored to be with you tonight. I was trying to talk about sharing responsibility. I have a verse in the Quran. Talk about how a human being is a fool. Or how a man is a fool. God mentioned that responsibility has been put in front of the mighty creation of God. Mountains, skies, everything. And they refused to take it. Then he made it simpler. And who accepts to take it? Is man and woman. So what God said at the end of the day, they made fool out of themselves because they are ignorant of the enormity of responsibility. And this is what we are seeing, the outcome of death on the third world countries. People give money to other people who knew that they are corrupt. And they know that they are corrupt. Corrupt government, corrupt individual, corrupt regime, failing states. But they still give the money to them, and they don't take the responsibility. And to make the nations to be responsible for the wrongdoing of their governments. A system which needs to be changed. I'm not promoting for Islam today. I don't need to do that. Because I believe in what I believe, it's personal matter for me. But I'm promoting for justice and equality and fairness amongst all of us. A system that tell me I am wrong when I am wrong. When you look about how Europe now is dealing with the problem in Ireland, economical problem in Ireland, in Greece, how many tens of billions of dollars has been spent to keep Greece as one nation or a viable nation? If we could have spent all this on canceling the debts, removing the debts, on the third world countries. What source of inspiration we could have given to millions and tens and hundreds of millions of people in Africa and Asia. And this is the double standard of our economical system. We created something, we become a monster. Frankenstein monster, that's it. I wrote a blog on my blog page about Frankenstein monster. And we create a monster at the backyard. And we keep feeding our monster. One day, if we don't have food to feed him, he will eat us. And this is why the monster came here to Europe, came to Ireland, came to the mainland of Europe, came to UK, as we call it, economical crisis, came to France, came to America, came to everywhere. But we do not admit that we are wrong. And this is another double standard, because we don't want to commit that we are wrong. And you can listen to somebody come from Africa or from Asia or from Latin America who has a solution in his or her, on her hand. And this is the arrogance. Arrogance is the twin brother of ignorance. Both of them go together. If I am ignorant, I am arrogant. If I am arrogant, because I am ignorant. This is the problem. Sharing responsibility is the name of the game. We have to play it. Justly, not by talking about it. Belief is the cornerstone. No one of us by the rules of God can claim that he or she can live on this planet without having a sort of faith in their heart, in their life. Sort of way of life. Jesus, peace be upon him, said, I am the way. That's right. What do you say in your religion? To respond to Jesus, say? He is the way.
You find? God is the way.
God is the way. Okay. Similar. So we can't live without a faith. Because this is the part of the nature of creation of man. And even animals. And even birds. And even trees. And everything. Because the Creator is the one who creates every one of us according to what he wants to give us of characteristics. Not according to our likeness. Or our desires. Okay? So when I put the belief at the beginning as a solution, will lead us to respect, look forward for people, engage, empower, develop, and make them independent. I'm talking about solution based on the cornerstone of belief. Then when we become independent, we'll be able to produce a valuable commodity for humanity based on the faith we have. But we have, while we are doing all this, to believe in two or three things. Connectivity, networking, and partnership. Because we cannot do it alone. No matter what we have of wealth, of power, of knowledge, we have to build coalition. We are living in an era which is not an individual can do everything, it is us. Not the small us of the Indian, of the Arabs, or the Pakistani, or the Anglo-Saxon, or the African, the big us of all of us. Not anymore. With the new revolution of technology, no one can do it alone. Are we politicizing our aid, militarizing our aid, politicizing our trade as well? Yes. We might be. Coming from the background of humanitarian work, the aid now is very much politicized. Even, unfortunately, in certain areas, militarized. This is a fact, and heartbreaking fact. And trade is following. A statement by one of the politicians said that if your sexual experience does not agree with our sexual experience, I will prevent you from having aid. Don't say who's he, because I don't know him, but you know him. If people do not promote certain kind of sexual experience, so we might actually not be happy to give them aid. The aid is not his government money. The aid is the people money. We pay the tax, we give the aid, and the government has to follow the desire of the nation, not the desire of one man. My personal life is my personal life. But the community, if my community is suffering, we have to respond to it swiftly from the public money, not from the individual money, whether this individual become president or a king or a queen, because we are not their wealth. We are not their properties. We are not their servants. We are servants of our nation. So we are the people who made them to come to offices. It's clear. And it's sad. We militarizing, we criticizing our aid and sometimes our trade. Talked about Greece. So what is the role of the global institution nowadays toward the debt campaign or the debt on the third world countries? Most of the global institution, unfortunately, are controlled by rich countries, without mentioning. Okay? Private sector, who is leading the country nowadays? The government or the private sector? It's very clear that the money in the hand of the private sector, not in the in the 11 Downing Street, what do you call it, 11 or 10?
11.
11. It's not there. So we listen to what Jesus said, money lender. What did Jesus say in the Bible? What is the MC? I told you, you are the MC, I'm the BBC. What Jesus say by to the money lender? Oh, come on, say it.
Get out of my, you've turned my house into a den of thieves instead of a house.
Come on, what did he ask them to do to the money lenders in the church when they put their tables there and they...
Get out.
Get out, what else? I'm just trying to refresh our memory of Bible teaching.
Pay back what you took.
What? Only what you took. Only what you took.
Double.
No, not double. We'll never say double. Only what you took. And if you take the gown or the garment of your neighbor, give it to him before the night falls. This is Jesus, peace be upon him, teaching. And this is somebody who was showing the way to humanity, how they can proceed and follow his teaching. Are we the followers of Jesus? Or we categorize the money lending? Because we became a part of a structured system, a structured economical system that is governing our life. Doesn't care about the poor, but care about the wealth of the wealthy. Bank managers and governments should be responsible, should be made responsible for the debts, because they gave the money to those corrupt governments, to those corrupt individuals, while they are off the hook. And me, in Somalia, or in Mozambique, or Zimbabwe, or India, are suffering as a citizen because of the wrongdoing of both parties. And this is not democracy. And this is not fairness, and this is not justice. The role of civil society is one of the solutions that we have to build civil society organization no matter what. Because this is the answer, or one of the key answers of our problems. Those people in Africa and in Asia are as good as we are. Let us train them, empower them, develop them, build the capacity to fight the debt with the kind of country is having. The role of youth, as my colleague, we met in New York or Washington, D.C.
New York.
And we sang together.
We did.
But we did not dance together.
No.
You need to learn the art of diplomacy. Not the art of shouting and become hot-headed. Because when you shout and become hot-headed, you can't hear what you're saying. You can't see who's in front of you. And you make mistakes. The art of diplomacy, of negotiation, and building community. And we want you, at your generation, to remove from Oxford Dictionary a word called debt. If you fail to do it, you must put it on your agenda. You must do it. They won't be better than us of achieving what we fail to achieve. Social media is another power. Could bring president to the office. Barack Obama came through social media, is that right? And could take president from the office. Hosni Mubarak was the other one. Gaddafi was the third one. Tunisia, Ibn Ali, Tunisia or Syria?
Syria.
And Ibn Ali from Tunisia, and she's hoping for the Syrian president also to be taken from his office and the American president. That's what your wish, huh? So, how can we use the language of the time? Social media is the power of the language of the change maker. And you have to become change maker to make the change. This is another role that you have to do. I'm not going here to put a lot of solution for that, but we need to make a fresh start. Every day is a fresh start to renew our blood and to believe in what we are doing. and keep focusing on the delivery of the product which can serve all of us, not me and my family, me and my nation, me and my tribe. And just to complement the role of women, which you mentioned nicely, about the role of women, the greatest four women had been mentioned 1430 years ago by Prophet Muhammad, were Lady Mary the Virgin, peace be upon her, the mother, the wife of Pharaoh. Any Jewish brother here? Sister? See, who hosted, the wife of Pharaoh hosted the baby Moses, peace be upon him. Moses was Egyptian, isn't it? Debatable.
He was Hebrew.
No, I'm talking about his nationality. He was born in Egypt, so give him an Egyptian passport. So I think the passport was not green at that time, it was blue. That looked like the star of them. So the wife of Pharaoh, I can't remember his name in Hebrew, her name?
Batya.
We call her Asya in Arabic. And she was one of the greatest women that has been acknowledged by Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Then his wife and his daughter, this is home, sweet home. But when this is acknowledgement of the global role of woman to humanity, when you look at those icons, see, especially the Mary and the wife of Pharaoh, what they have done to humanity of sheltering this great personality which came to save humanity as well. So you have a great role to play. Don't undermine your power and the force of your power and the drive that you can make for humanity. So if we believe that we can remove debt, we can change the economical system, we can bring a new economical system to the globe, we'll do it collectively. And if we agree to do it, we'll start today. Because civilization starts as an idea at the back of one individual, could be you. And in 40, 50, 60, 70 years time, could develop to a great civilization. Or a great social revolution that can change the face of humanity. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to talk to you and to learn from my colleague and my friend and from my... Come on, hand in hand.